The other way.
Where are you taking me?
The main gate.
Colonel! Colonel, I must know what you think has been going on here.
You want to know what I think?
Yes.
I think you're some kind of deviated prevert. I think General Ripper found out about your preversion and that you were organizing some kind of mutiny of preverts. Now move! On top of that, I don't know anything about any planes attacking Russia. All I was told to do was get General Ripper on the phone with the President of the United States.
Now, just one second. You just said the President.
What about the President?
Now, the President wants to speak to General Ripper, doesn't he? Now, General Ripper is dead, is he not?
I am General Ripper's executive officer, so the President will bloody well want to speak to me, won't he? There's a telephone box over there, and the line may be open.
You want to talk to the President of the United States?
I don't want to talk to him, Colonel. I've got to talk to him. And I can assure you, if you don't put that gun away and stop this stupid nonsense, the court of inquiry on this will give you such a pranging, you'll be lucky if you end up wearing the uniform of a bloody toilet attendant.
Okay, go ahead. Try and get the President of the United States on the phone. If you try any perversions in there, I'll blow your head off.
Operator, this is Group Captain Lionel Mandrake. I'm speaking from Burpleson Air Force Base. Look, something very urgent has come up, and I want you to place an emergency person-to-person call with President Merkin Muffley in the Pentagon, Washington, D.C. Burpleson 39180. No, I'm perfectly serious, operator. The President, yes, the President of the United States. Oh, I'm sorry, I haven't got enough change. Could you make this a collect call, operator? Just one second, operator. They won't accept the call. Have you got 55 cents?
Well, you don't think I'd go into combat with loose change in my pocket, do you?
Operator, look, is it possible to make this an ordinary trunk call? Well, what do you call it? You know, station to station. Oh, blast. I'm still 20 cents short. Operator, hold on one. I shan't give you a second. Colonel, that Coca-Cola machine, I want you to shoot the lock off it. There may be some change in there.
That's private property.
Colonel, can you possibly imagine what is going to happen to you, your frame outlook, way of life and everything, when they learn that you have obstructed a telephone call to the President of the United States? Can you imagine? Shoot it off! Shoot with a gun! That's what the bullets are for, you twit!
Okay. I'm gonna get your money for you. But if you don't get the President of the United States on that phone, you know what's gonna happen to you?
What?
You're gonna have to answer to the Coca-Cola company.